Hey guys, welcome back to Fox Plays Zelda Breath of the Wild. We are gonna go to our third shrine by climbing up some mountains. Okay, so we're gonna get up as high as we can before we start climbing, just so we have the utmost possibility of not dying. Okay, so we're in a dangerously cold area, but I don't think we're going to be in it for long. So I'm not really going to worry about our warmth at this point. There we go. So now we're not that cold anymore. Although we do need to go up higher. So maybe we should. Yeah, what we're gonna do is eat the spicy pepper steak, because it'll heal us up, but also make us warm, give us cold resistance. You can see that over in the corner. Now we're gonna straight up need to climb up this rock face. Shouldn't be a problem. Okay, so we made it. Okay, I see. So the little temperature gauge works how the blue and the red are what is unsurvivable for us. It's not that it's just extra cold. If we're in the blue or the red, then we need protection from it. But since we have the spicy pepper steak cold resistance, the blue is smaller, which is useful. That's not what I wanted, but I wonder if I can blow up that thing. No. Okay, nope, can't do that. But maybe, what was it that we got in here? I played it yesterday and I can't remember the bonus rune that we got in here. But not a big deal, because we're about to go through it. Okay, we'll skip that. I'll go down here. Oh, I remember now. Okay, Oa Dime is the is the goddess of this shrine, or the monk or whatever. I'm glad I don't owe her a dime. So this one's got a cool bonus rune that we get. Basically stops things from moving, or you'll see. It's pretty cool. Stasis rune. Very cool. Okay, so we, as you can see, can stop things from moving. We can stop them, put them into a stasis. Okay, now there's a cooldown period. But obviously we're going to be stopping that boulder from moving. We're gonna wait for it to be right here, and then stop it. And then run past it. I don't know if it'll keep moving after we unstop it. Yep, it will. So, what we wanna do here is, oh, no, because there's a, just like I said. Gotta wait till Let's change our weapon for what we're about to do. Now, if we hit something while it's stopped, it'll basically have potential energy within. And since it won't fall into the pit, a new one's not going to fall on us. But that's how we'll get that boulder out of the way when we go back outside, is by stasis, using stasis. Ooh, a traveler shield. That is a better shield. So let's equip it. Alright, so now we're going to pick up this warhammer. An iron sledgehammer, but I need space. Let's drop one of these axes. And now we're gonna put this in stasis. It's gonna go super far. Oh, that was awesome. Okay. And our Boko Club is badly damaged, but that's alright, because it's not that great, and we can get a billion of them from fighting enemies. But we have completed our third shrine, so good job, everybody. So we got our third spirit orb. We are one more. Oh, we need one more. And I know exactly where to go to get it. So that's pretty cool. And I'll skip that little thing because it's the same as the others. Yeah, so we can. One thing we haven't looked at is that with the bombs, we are able to get a square or a circular bomb just for certain situations, which is just a real. Like, as a gameplay mechanic, that's very nice. Like, it can save from a whole lot of heartache sometimes, I think. So let's stop time on that. Hit it. Oh, we broke our Boko Club, but it's alright, because that thing's gonna go freaking flying. Okay, maybe not flying, but we hit it. And now we can open this chest. And get a new traveler's bow. I don't know how long traveler's bows last, but we have a second one, just in case. Okay, so instead of having to climb a whole bunch to get out of here, we want to get over here, so maybe the best way would be to go. And we have cold resistance for a little bit longer. So let's see if we can get over to that fourth shrine by traveling this way. Okay, so there's a bunch of boulders up here. And there's a bunch of bad guys. Well, I think we should have some fun. And even if we don't make it, we could. It's alright. Because I still have ingredients to make another spicy pepper steak. So, we're gonna do this because it sounds awesome. Let's see. We wanna probably hit this one to hit those barrels. Oh, let's equip a weapon, of course. Bokoblin arm. Okay, come on. We need a good. There we go. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. That was the worst possible thing. We are going to run away very quickly. Oh no. Okay. We're going to also... use this to get those off our back. My Bokoblin arm is badly damaged. It's okay, I'm gonna get the claymore out. Kill those guys. Okay, I need... man, this is not going how I expected it to go. Alright, this guy, the freaking bow, needs to taste some of his own medicine. Or not. There we go. That's what I wanted. I wanted a giant explosion. Oh, nice. Okay, so if a treasure chest catches on fire, let's sit by the fire until morning so it's bright out again. If a treasure chest catches on fire, then it simply disappears and the item inside it pops out. So that's really nice. Okay, so we need... oh, I am on fire right now. We need to create... it's not going to help us in the cold unless we put it in some sort of dish. So right now, it's not useful to us. What we need is a cooking pot. That's not what I wanted. That's okay. And these guys with these bows. Super annoying. Yeah, get out of here. But I want whatever's in this. I don't even care what it is. I want your stuff. Alright, more arrows. Good. Now, I can pick up a few things here. Be by the fire for a little bit, and then... okay, so there's the shrine we want to get to. We just need to get to it. And it might be smart to start going farther down where it's not as cold to find a place where we can cook food. Let's climb down. Oh, nope. Oh, wow. We did not take any fall damage there. That was amazing. Okay, so we're still going to be... it's still too cold for us. And we are running out of cold resistance, so we need to get out of here. And I think we're in a good spot to do that. Cool. Oh, that's the Temple of Time. Awesome. Should be a cook pot somewhere. Oh, there's one right there. Alright, and now we're in a good spot. Awesome. And I'm gonna throw this to murder some dudes. Wow, well played. I'll give you that one, that was a good shot. Man, so combat in this is pretty fun. Like, it's difficult in a fun way. Okay, let's bust out the axe. And there we go. Okay, so now we can go use their cooking pot. And we can get the steak off their spit here. Got some spicy peppers. Very convenient. Be able to cook. Let's cook several of these Alright, let's cook. Let's see if we just cook. Okay, do I need to also hold a mushroom? Okay, I don't want to drop them. I want to cook them. What is the issue here? Okay, I want to hold this with a mushroom and a spicy pepper. Do I need to light it? Is that the problem? Oh, that's... Okay. We're gonna bust out our torch here. Light the torch. There we go. Hold. 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 Cook. Perfect. Okay, we need to see if we can find another bird or two to cook some more spicy pepper steaks. I also wonder if we don't actually need to use a mushroom on that, because it's a spicy pepper steak. There's a seared steak. That's nice. I hear birds. Can I see them somewhere? There is... Whoa, is that the Master Sword? Okay, I don't care what I was doing. We're gonna go check that out right now. And we just fell like a rock into the water, but that's okay. Stamina is used constantly while you're swimming, which is interesting. Oh, just a rusty broadsword. Okay, no problem. We can dive, it looks like. Let's catch some fish if we can. Oh, X to dash. Oh, like climbing. It's the same button we use to climb, or to dash when we climb. Okay. Let's see if we can find another bird or two for more meat. Oh, yeah, I don't want to use that. Okay, I want to use... Nope, let's use our rusty broadsword. I'm gonna climb back up here, even though this is close to where we started the game, actually. Looking for birds, because I want more spicy pepper steaks. That guy is just everywhere we go. Old man's following us around. We are actually quite a distance from where we want to be, so I don't want to use my pepper steak again. But I want to climb down here. Now, I think our stamina goes down slower when we are climbing down instead of up. I'm not positive about that, though. We're going to aim for this little ledge here where we can get our stamina back up. Oh, that was not a ledge. Okay, well, that worked out well anyway. That could have been bad. Didn't need to climb down the whole thing, could just slide across down the rocks and save from getting damaged. These are some pretty strong cliffs. We're in a cool little forest area, though, which is very pretty. Looks like a thing I've never gotten before. Hyrule Herb. Increases a full heart, which we can use it to cook with, too. Got a Bokoblin encampment over there that I'm not worried about. Looks like we can climb. This might be a good spot to climb over here. The fire. We got Bokoblins in there too. I feel like Frodo, Sam, and Gollum when we're climbing up the secret stairs outside of Cirith Ungol. Or Minas Morgul, not Cirith Ungol. Well, it is near Cirith Ungol, actually. Anyway. Just, they're right there and don't even notice me climbing up this rock face. Okay, I think we'll be able to get up to this next spot where we can recover our stamina. Cool. And then we'll keep climbing. Nice. Just a little short one here. We can easily jump up. Let's go see what that mysterious thing is. Okay, so we got... Nope, don't want that. Oh, it looks metal, and we can pick it up and put it in the... we'll put it... where it came from. There we go. What does that give us? Oh, nice. I found him. Okay. I like these simple little puzzles and those like goofy looking guys. Probably could have jumped across, but that's all right. Okay, so let's look at our map. Nice, we're on a good path, I think. We want to climb, possibly just climb up that. Let's see what, well, let's see. Oh no, we definitely want to... Let's get down over here and climb up this little broken section of the wall. So, there it is. Now we just need to get across. There's a little tower thing here. And that's begging to be climbed up. Oh, got a cool treehouse looking thing. I actually want to take these guys out. Come on, roll farther. Nope, that didn't work. It's okay, we'll use one and throw it up on their platform with them. Okay, that didn't seem to work very well. Okay, let's just arrow them in the face. Yep, my bow is damaged. Okay. Nice. I mean, it broke, but... Wrong button. Took that guy out. Now it looks like we need to cut these to get up there. We got some spicy peppers down here too. Okay. Now we fight this guy with our rusty broadsword, which broke very quickly. Yep, time to axe him. Ask him a question. Do you want to die? That's the question I'm asking. I'm axing him. Oh, that would have been cool. Alright, let's jump attack him. Nice. Took him out. Two fangs and a horn. And two chests up here. Amber. Peppers, some mushrooms back here, there's a bridge right there, ooh, with some arrows, that was useful, okay, so, we're gonna stop this episode here, because we're real close, but it's already been a pretty long episode, so in the next episode, we will make our way to the other shrine, and then or maybe I'll even get there in the middle. Anyway, in the next episode, we're going to tackle that fourth shrine and have all the spirit orbs that we need to get the paraglider. All right, guys. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on Fox Plays Zelda Breath of the Wild. Bye.